talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
All right, welcome, welcome. This is WDC Radio. I'm your host. I am WDC. I want to thank you for tuning in today. I got a nice show for you coming up. I got my teammates out coming out here. No Pain in the Playroom is going to be in the building. They're making their way here right now. And just going to have an action-packed show for you. Got some music playing for you in the background. That's my theme song. You can get that on iTunes, 99 cents. Got our instrumental version. This is the rap version with Curtis Blow. That's right. Legendary rapper and pastor Curtis Blow, Young Ice, and IG the Great. Check this out. Be right back.
Favorite sport, you know I like the way the dribble up and down the court, fast and slow. 25 years ago, the WDC and it's me, your man Curtis Blow, from Dr. J to Michael Jordan to Kevin Durant, who leads the whole league in scoring. Wayne Wade down in Miami, making a name. I love this game to the NBA Hall of Fame. Slam dunk, alley-oops, and the give and go. Vince Carter, Superman, and my man Carmelo and Rondo over in Boston with the big three, captivating audiences across the country and ruling the world like LeBron the King. I say, man, Kobe sure has a lot of rings. I do my thing, not for the bling bling in the amount. It's the NBA Finals, so what's the count?
So the first half of the show, we're going to be talking about stopping sickle sex. Yes, stopping sickle sex. And not necessarily stopping it, but also just having a conversation about it. A lot of kids were born and the parents had no idea that they had the sickle cell trait or thalassemia trait. So when I say stop it, it's disappearing the ignorance around it and having people informed so they get to make informed choices when it comes to parenting and having parenting options and choices. So that's the Stop Sickle Sex campaign. It's my man Alan Emmanuel. It's Jody Johnson, a.k.a. DBC, myself, and shouts out the girl for sickle cell, Krishan. She's a part of the team, too. So we'll be talking about that for a little bit in the beginning. And then I got No Pain in the Playroom, like I said, coming up on the second half of the show. And we'll be right back again. This is the theme song. This is my man, Young Ice.
My life, I've been a fighter. Greatest upset in history, noted the sports writer. Put me in the Olympics, I'm guaranteed I'm the torchlighter. Provider of all the lyrics that are blowing scorch fire. I'm in the locker room, getting my ass taped. Biggest speed of a cheater, the strength of a man, eight. I'm feeling bad what I'm about to do to this man's face. But he the opponent, so I'm on the loss I can't take. Hands like Mayweather, swag like Ali. You think you way better, homie, than I see. And then I think they call me Hitman, Tommy Hearns. And y'all be biting like Tyson, I learned. And I don't gotta be flashy in front of the camera. All I do is show my warrior heart like you can. Never been knocked out, but I've been knocked down. Long as I make it to the next round, what's the count?
All right, so this is Sickle Cell Awareness Month. In case you didn't know, this is WDC Radio. We're celebrating Sickle Cell Awareness Month. And, man, I got people calling me. You got to call into the show, man. So, again, September is Sickle Cell Awareness Month. A lot of conversation out there going on in the Facebook world, man. That social media is no joke. You got some people complaining that Sickle Cell Awareness Month has nothing to do with the trait. And how can you talk about sickle cell disease without the trait? Because that's what creates the disease. So, you know, people have their own feelings and opinions, which is cool. I mean, you know, you're allowed to have that. But let's look at the reality of sickle cell disease. And that's what we're going to talk about today. Some reality conversation, having sickle sex in regards of knowing what's in your genes. I don't think a lot of people talk about our gene pool and where our ancestors are from, which is important. I've had guests with sickle cell SD, sickle cell thalassemia. So we're going to see who's on the line right now and go live and with some conversation here. I don't want to hear myself talk no more. You're live. What's the count?
Hello?
Yes.
Hi, my name is Charlize, and, you know, I'm living with sickle cell. I'm 22 years old. I have a son, which is a blessing, and I'm married. And, you know, like you said, without the trait, there wouldn't be any sickle cell. When I was born, my mom, she knew she had the trait, but my dad didn't know.
Right.
And my mom told my dad, and, you know, they wound up having me. And when I was 2 years old, my hand swelled up, and my mom didn't know why. She knew I didn't smash my hand in the door.
Right.
You know, she knew, you know, didn't know accident happened.
Right.
So she took me to the hospital, and she found out that I had sickle cell disease.
Wow.
Growing up, I was in pain. And, you know, my mom never really sat me down and said, hey, you know, you have an illness. She never really sat me down. I just knew that I went to the doctor often to get, you know, blood drawn.
Right.
So I moved from Chicago to Atlanta, Georgia. And this is when I was about 10. And okay. I remember going into my first crisis.
Wow.
It was hell. I'm just going to say it was crazy. I was throwing up. I didn't feel good. I didn't know what was going on.
Right.
And when I went to the hospital, I got strong medication that made me sometimes feel worse,
right.
Hallucinate and things like that. But now that I've gotten used to it, because I've been dealing with sickle cell my entire life.
Right.
But being hospitalized, I've been dealing with it for, you know, 13, 14 years of being in the hospital back to back to back.
Right.
Right now, I'm in the hospital as we speak.
So right now, let the listeners know, right now, you are calling from your hospital room.
Yes, sir.
All right,
I am.
See, now that's, I want to thank you for doing that, for calling in, because I just want people to know that this disease, the disorder is real, and it affects people from all around the world, all around the country, male, female, adults, and children. And I want to thank you for being a true soldier. And in the midst of what you're battling with the sickle cell disease, that you're able to call in, and you still want people to hear your voice and find out, you know, what's going on, what's the count with sickle cell. And it's not a bad thing. You know, it's truly a blessing, like you say, that your mom had you, because in this war on sickle cell, I mean, who else to tell those stories so people can get educated? It's not a bad thing. And you having your child is also a blessing, because of what the doctors say, the odds of you having a child and what could happen if you have a child. So when we say stop sickle sex, we're not saying that it's a bad thing. My point is just to be informed, because a lot of families don't get that choice. And maybe someone will, you know, change their mind on having that child with that mate and create other ways to have a family. So thank you for calling in and sharing your story.
Thank you. And, you know, like even if you do, you know, you have sickle cell, just get your partner tested.
Right.
I got my partner tested, and my son, he has the trait, and right. I'm going to let him know when he gets older, be careful who you sleep with.
Right.
I'm not saying, you know, don't fall in love and meet your somebody and don't have a kid. I'm saying just be careful. My son will be 2 on the 1st of January. And I'm just happy to see that. I'm happy to see that my doctor is still helping me live. And I just want everybody to know my story. And I want everybody to, you know, get yourself tested. Be safe. Because it's nothing to play with. It's nothing to play with. And so no one likes to see their family in pain.
So let me ask you a question. When you started dating your mate, were you able to open up and share with them about your condition? Are you under your disorder?
Yes, I was. You know, actually, I would have to say my husband, his name is Terry. Hi, baby. I know you're listening. I love you. We were friends before we were boyfriend and girlfriend.
Okay.
And even as friends, he was in the hospital with me when I would go into crisis.
Okay.
So he knew, and he wanted to help me.
That's
so
awesome.
he never judged me or anything like that.
That's awesome.
He wanted to be by my side the whole way through, and he still is.
So when you decided or had made that choice to have a child with him after he got tested, did the doctors give you any kind of, you know, warning, or what did they tell you when you made that choice?
You know what? I was mad at the doctors. I was really mad because when I turned 18 weeks, they kind of came to me and was like, you know, you might not make it, or your baby might not make it, or, you know, if you don't make it, he might make it.
Right.
And they was like, do you want to have an abortion? And I literally looked at the doctor,
right,
and I told her, I said, this is not some cult you could take back to Brelton Cult Factory. You know, my son didn't ask to be here. I told my husband, I told my friends, I would die for this kid because he didn't ask to be here. You
right.
know,
exactly.
I was the one who decided to, you know, go ahead and be an adult and have a kid. I'm going to have my kid,
and
no matter if I do die.
And one of the things, you know, there's a lot of things in place. Like you say, they can find out why you're during your pregnancy. There's newborn screening. They can find out after the child's born. Again, just my own opinion is that's still after the fact. And having to put you in a situation like that to now you have to decide you're going to terminate your pregnancy or, you know, live with a child who could have sickle cell disease. I mean, how many parents have gone through that? The added stress to that, you know?
I know that it's very hard because my son is only 2 and he's very smart to be his age. And he cries when I have to go. And it's hard to sit there and listen to my son scream while I'm walking into the hospital and the doors are closing. I hear my son screaming because his mom has to go to the hospital.
Right.
And I'm not there for weeks.
Right.
Sometimes months. When I get sick, I go every month, and normally I stay for a month. You know, for the past, I've been doing good. I stayed out for 3 months, thanks to my doctor, Dr. Collins at Emory. He's the best doctor ever, and he does everything he can for his sickle cell patients. He does everything.
How?
And I am so blessed to have a doctor like him.
How does your husband handle? How does he handle the stress when he goes to see you, to the hospital?
My husband, he tries to stay strong. And, you know, I'm not going to lie, it's very difficult on him because I'm told that he gets into this mood. And not only am I told this, but I see it.
Yeah.
My husband gets into this depressive mood to where he's just all sidetracked when I'm not at home.
Oh,
like,
wow.
The only thing he does is he'll work. He'll watch the baby, and he'll play his video games to get it off his mind.
Yes,
but
the release.
My husband don't know that I know he cries sometimes.
Oh, wow.
And I tell him he has to stay strong for the baby. You know, we both can't be crying.
Right.
You know, we can't let our son see us like this. We can't. So one of us has to be stronger than the other. And I know it's hard for my husband, and you know, all I could tell him is don't cry.
Right.
I'm going to be okay. Just know that I'm going to be okay. And just continue to pray. Just know I'm coming back home. And if I'm not, and if I don't, you know I'm always by your side. And I will always love you.
Okay. I want you to hold the line. I got a couple more callers calling in, so I'm going to bring them on the line. So don't go nowhere. You live at What's the Count? Just bring them all.
You live what's going on?
What's up?
I'm good, man. This is Alan.
Hey, Alan, what's the count, man?
I'm good. I've been trying to get in the line, and for some reason, I've been getting.
You good, man? We got you. We got a lot going on right now. So just hold on. We got one more caller coming in. You're live at What's the Count?
What's the count?
Hey,
Dr.
Bailey, how
you
doing? My favorite doctor in the world.
I'm doing all right. How are you?
We're doing great. I have a guest on the line, and she was sharing. She's calling from the hospital, from her bed. She's calling from the hospital, sharing her story and her input about having sickle sex and what it looks like and how her parents found out. And so, Dr. Bailey, just what do you want to say about the impact and the results of people who are having sickle sex. You have anything you want to say on that perspective?
Well, I know that everyone has to have their own opinion and their own decision on what they will do, who they will and will not date. I think that I can respect that, but I also, education is key. Understand exactly what you're getting into. Understand how the genetics work.
Right.
And if you're SS and your partner is SS, your children will definitely be SS. There's no question about it.
Right.
So, they're going to make their own decision, of course. And everyone, it's their right to make that decision.
Exactly.
But I personally, it's a deal breaker for me because I am half sickle cell. I'm just not willing to go there. If I end up marrying a man with sickle cell, I know that we will have to make the decision to adopt. That's my personal opinion.
And Dr. Bailey, I just want people to understand that when it comes to sickle cell, like yourself, you have SC. So you want to find out what your mate has in all aspects of those red blood cell conditions, because just because you say, do you have sickle cell trait, and they say no, there could be thalassemia, there could be hemoglobin C, there could be D, there could be other genes that could cause a form of sickle cell disease. Is that correct?
Exactly. You want to know what's on your hemoglobin gene. You want to know that entire gene, what hemoglobinopathy you could possibly carry. Any of them. It could be hemoglobin Monroe. It could be hemoglobin Punjabi. It could be anything. If
right.
it's there and it is co-inherited with the sickle trait, it becomes problematic.
And one last thing I want to share is that I posted some stuff on my Instagram at IMWDC, and someone left a message back, and she said that she had sickle cell trait. She had a daughter, but the daughter was born with thalassemia trait. And when they tested her, she found out that she had both, the mom carried both genes because they're set up on different parts of the gene strand. Is that true? Is that possible?
Yes, it's very possible. Absolutely.
Okay.
There's quite a few people that inherit various different combinations. They're not all, the mutation isn't in the exact same place. It
right.
affects the same gene, but it's in a different place or on a different locus. But it still can cause the illness, and it's all about what you have in your cocktail, how it affects your body,
right.
and then what you have the potential of passing on to your children.
Exactly. So I have my partner, my teammate here, Alan Emmanuel, who is part of the Stop Sickle Sex campaign, and he's the stop in the sickle sex part of the conversation. So, Alan, please share with the listeners who you are, man, and what you care about in this Stop Sickle Sex campaign.
Well, yeah, thank you for introducing me. My name is Alan Emmanuel, as you just mentioned, and I'm a singer-songwriter, and I am the stop portion in this whole sickle sex campaign. And I think the reason why we feel it's so important to even expand and expose the campaign this way is because there are so many facets to it, and it affects everybody very differently. So for us, we felt that we wanted to kind of have the conversation to let people know that, look, you know, just because you are like Dr. Bailey just said, you're carrying a particular trait, your response to it may be very different from somebody else's.
Right.
So what we're doing is just expanding the conversation, exposing the realities of the disease,
right.
and asking people to make choices that make sense. You know, as Dr. Bailey says, you're not telling anybody what to do.
No.
For me, it's a deal breaker as well. But I think anybody you meet who has the disease, who understands the disease,
right.
would understand that it's an issue of ignorance. And so, as she mentioned, the very first thing I think we should mention is that education is key.
Yes.
Like your campaign, what's in your genes? That's a campaign that really just brings out that conversation, and I think that's a campaign that we're going to continue to bring across the both California and across the nation to let people know, look, you need to know what's in your genes, what's really there.
Right.
And then there's another aspect to this that I think is important to have a conversation about, Faron, and that's the fact that we need to look at how healthcare approaches the disease from a comprehensive way. And I was talking to you yesterday, I know you remember, I was talking about this particular girl that I saw an article about who just recently, this was in the UK, she, you know, was mistreated by the EMS. And because of that, the EMTs or whatever, so because of that, she ended up dying.
Right.
And some of the stuff that I saw on that post, I thought it was remarkable, because one of the healthcare professionals that came through put a comment and said, well, you know, she knew exactly what medication she wanted. This is somebody who had sickle cell.
Right.
And this is the point I'm making. You know, because she knew exactly what pain medication she needed, she was he automatically said that's the action of a drug seeker. So I could understand how she could possibly get poor treatment.
Right.
So that mentality is still out there in the healthcare world.
Of course.
So that's another part of the whole Stop Sickle Sex campaign that really we're bringing out, which is there are health discrepancies. There are people being treated in certain ways simply on the basis of stigmas, not reality, but stigmas. Yeah.
Hey, Alan, hold on. We got one more. I got a caller to bring on the line. Hold on, let me see what this is. You're live at What's the Count? You're live. Don't be shy.
Hello?
Hello? Who's this? Hello? All right, go ahead, Alan. We're going to continue on.
Okay, so you know, as I was saying, there are health discrepancies, and I think it's important to mention that. I think the other thing is, in the whole conversation of, you know, gene testing and how to do that, I think one of the things we could mention is the Medilab, which we're working with the sickle cell, Stop Sickle Sex campaign.
Definitely.
The Medilab is one opportunity in California that people can set now and go find out what is in your genes. You know, tell people directly, hey, this is a problem and you can fix it. That's the part that I when I hear stop, I hear action.
Exactly.
I hear an action word that says there's something you can do.
And
it doesn't matter if you are trait carrier, you know, disease carrier, there's something you can do.
It's really just disappearing the ignorance around the conversation about it, because it's just, for some reason, it's just not being had to the capacity. I remember talking to Dr. Bailey before. You still there, Dr. Bailey? She there? I remember talking to you one time, and we were talking about, you know, just this whole sickle cell community and the medical doctors, and you said to me that it's our responsibility to get the message out. It's up to us. If we wait for them to do it, it may never happen. It's been 103 years, and the conversation is where
it's at.
And Dr. Bailey, that still rings in my head, that it's our responsibility to take this bull by the horn and get the message out of whatever it takes. And if it's talking about sex in a conversation of related to sickle cell, then that's what it's going to be. All right, let's see. We got another caller. You're live at What's the Count?
Hey.
Who's this?
The real Chaff City.
What's up? What you got? What's up? What you got to say about stopping sickle sex, man?
Man, people just need to get more aware of what's going on out here.
Yeah.
And to know your partner, you know what I'm saying? If this is because you see somebody, you got to know what's really good for you and your future, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. So,
I mean, we have to understand there's an impact in the result of the decisions that we make in life. Not just having sex, but any decision you make is an impact in the result.
Correct. And for Ron, if you don't mean, I think the caller for calling in, I just want to kind of comment this. You know, the conversation about that we need to have on a national level about stopping sickle sex is not a strange concept, because if you think about it, when HIV first came out, what did the government do immediately?
Oh, yeah.
They started putting out campaigns saying that, hey, look, there's something that you can prevent, and if we partner together, you do your part by having safe sex, we do our part by trying to prevent the disease in other ways, we can actually fight the disease.
Right.
That's what's missing.
And that's not inherited. That's something that you can catch. We're talking about being born.
Correct.
We're talking about being born with this disease.
And you know what, to add on to that, and
I remember when Tay-Sachs is a disease that's genetic, it's inherited, and it specifically affects a particular family of Jews, the Ashkenazi Jews, this particular group of Jews, and their babies were being born with Tay-Sachs all the time until they figured out that it was genetic. They started this major campaign, get tested, get tested, get tested. And so that whenever two of this particular family of Jews were to, before they got married, they would get tested. And this campaign has single-handedly dropped the level of births to less than 1% in 10 years because of the putting it out there.
So we need to find that framework and just copy that framework and just start going at it, you know, and just start.
You know, that's why we're doing this, because I mean, at the end of the day, Dr. Bailey, that fact is exactly the point. You know, like, you look at how there's a possibility of changing something, and when you realize that the power is in your hands, and when I say in your hands, I mean my hands, and I mean the listener's hands. When you realize that that power is in your hands, and you can turn around, because it is too late if you wait until you have that child to find out what the disease is and how you're going to deal with it, because you already have a child with it.
All right,
and
let me see. Let me.
Out of ignorance.
We got another caller calling in. Hold on. You're live. What's the count?
Yep, that's true.
You're live. What's the count? Is that DC?
What's up? What's going on?
What's up?
Oh, man.
That's the sickle. That's the sickle. That's the sickle in the Stop Sickle Sex Conversation. What's up, DBC?
That's right. Wish I was there, man.
Ah, man, my chair is empty over here, man. What's up? What's the count? You got me on camera by myself, man.
Yeah, my car.
Hey,
you know that yourself.
We're surrounded
by a great crowd of witnesses.
Hey, so DBC, this I wanna ask DBC, man, in the sickle part of the Stop and Sickle Sex. You there?
Yeah.
What's your point of view for the sickle part in the Stop Sickle Sex, man? What do you want the community to know about the sickle part of this conversation, man?
Mm-hmm.
What do you want them to know about the sickle part, man? I mean, you're talking about, I mean, you live with the 5.1 count. They need to know the impact and the results of the sickle.
It's not what it is, man. We really need to take what we're doing to the next level. The world really, I truly believe the world, the doctors really doesn't know the depth of what sickle cell is, even with a person with the trait. You know, it's more than just us coming in there for medication. We really have needs, you know, thalassemia, all types. I got a call from my niece yesterday, and she said that her class, her teacher, nobody never heard of sickle cell at Long Beach City College. They had a lecture on it Friday. So we have to be the one to take it to the next level, man. If we let people know how it is living with sickle cell, how it is living with the trait. I have a son in Atlanta, still struggling, just like me with sickle cell. He has the trait.
Exactly.
And he said it's getting worse. They had to let him off of work early.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
It's that bad. So we just have to... And break the cycle up, man, of ignorance of what sickle cell really is.
Let me see if my original caller, are you still on the phone line there, calling from the hospital bed?
Yeah. Yes.
Now
I want
to ask you, because now we're talking about the sex part, and you had a child with your husband, with and he has a trait now. So what is your view? What do you want the women to know about having sickle sex and making that decision or choice to have a child?
Well, you know, the choice is always up to you. I know that everyone don't have the same views. You know, some people might feel like that they shouldn't keep their child, you know. But I mean, like I said, every female has different views.
Right.
If, you know, there's men out there who don't stay with their women once they get a girl pregnant, and I know that would be even harder,
right,
to find out that you have a child with sickle cell, and then, you know, you have no one to be there with you, to help you with anything.
Right.
Because I know without my husband, if my husband wasn't by my side, I would be somewhere lost, like really lost.
Wow.
It's hard. You know, you can't have your kid in the hospital every time you get sick.
Right.
You know? So the decision is up to the person. I would say this is, but make sure, I would just say, just get tested.
Yes.
Mainly African Americans, because the disease is mainly in, the illness is mainly in African American people.
Yeah.
That's the most, where the percentage is in African American people.
Oh, yeah.
I would just say get tested, and then if you do find out something like that, you know, make sure that you're with someone who wants to be with you and who's going to be with you. You know, you got to be careful, because everyone isn't meant to be a dad or a mom. You know, sometimes things just happen that way.
Right. And I want to add to your statement that is not, you know, African Americans, yes, we take ownership in this gene. But also, it's an ancestry thing. So you got to look back. So you have the Hispanic community is number two. You have Mediterranean, right, European. Right. So you have to look at, you know, we are interracial now. We all date other races. And so you want to find out what's in your genes. Because like I said, just because you have the trait, your mate could have thalassemia or hemoglobin C. And because they're not black doesn't mean that they don't carry that kind of gene. Or they could be white and have the sickle cell trait. So you really don't know unless you know.
Mainly in African Americans, number one. They're the number one. And then, like you said, Mexicans or Hispanic is number two.
That's number two. But it's an ancestry. What you got?
Can I just chime in real quick?
Real quick. I got to take a break. I got to take a break. So real quick.
All right. Just real quick. My mom just literally about 3 weeks ago told me, did you know that your great-grandfather was a Syrian? Now, that's something that I would have never known.
Wow.
Because if you look at my skin color, I'm a dark brother. So I just want to say it is important to just because you look at your skin tone, you know, like when you get into the hospital and they assume they know what's going on by the way you look, you really do have to go further than that and ask for some further testing to see what your genes actually have.
Right. All right, we'll be right back. This is WDC Radio. I'm your host. I am WDC. Shouts out to my guest panel here. And again, we'll be right back. WDC Radio, Sickle Cell Awareness Month.
Journey Sisters is an organization that embodies and captivates women from all walks of life. Our membership includes 44 women that are constantly growing in the areas of personal development and community involvement. Monthly, we offer free leadership classes at McCade's Restaurant. Journey aims to inform women in the areas of heart disease and HIV and AIDS. Experience the journey now by logging into www.journeymosaicinc.com. Toll free 888-906-5519. Journey with no excuses.
Are you having sickle sex?
Sickle sex?
Yeah, sickle sex. You won't know unless you've been tested.
Really? You can really get sickle cell from having sex?
No, but your baby can. If you carry the sickle cell trait, you could possibly have a baby with the sickle cell disease. Find out more today and get tested. This message brought to you by SCD Soldier Network.
Hey, what's up now? brother. What's up?
This is a good recording, man.
Yeah, brother, dig it. Solid. Right on.
All right, welcome back to WDC Radio. I'm your host. I am WDC. I just want to let everybody know that on September 30th, I'll be here live, like I'm every Monday. But I'm working on getting here, being here for about 3 hours. So I got to make sure I clear with the station. But we're doing a pledge for Sickle Cell Awareness Month. I'm doing a pledge because I'm launching my nonprofit, What's the Count on Sickle Cell Trait Prevention. That's my information. I'm a trait advocate, preventive. And so I'm going to be going around the city doing mobile testing. And so I'm raising funds so I can give these tests for free to the community. I don't want them to pay for it. So I'll be doing a pledge here for sure on the September 11th, starting at 11 o'clock. I'm going to have entertainment for you. I have guests here, performances, just a lot of conversation about this subject as well, stopping sickle sex. But also you'll be able to donate funds to a specific number that I'm going to text, that you'll be able to text to and or go to a link and donate and sponsor a test for someone in the community, because I'm going to be out sharing this message in the streets and I want to be able to test people and so they can find out what's in the genes. So that's what the pledge is going to be about, raising funds to be able to do that on a full-time basis for myself and for my teammates. So September 30th right here, LA Talk Live, WDC Radio. Check us out. Now back to this conversation. I'm waiting for No Pain in the Playroom. They're making their way in the building. So we're going to continue this conversation while I got Dr. Bailey and Alan and my other guests. So Dr. Bailey, she there? Dr. Bailey. DBC, put your phone on mute, man.
I'm here to just kind of expand on the pledge because I think it's so important.
All right, what you got?
We have that conversation about the pledge.
What you got?
I just wanted to say, look, everybody out there, whether you are part of the sickle cell community or not, we need your help with this pledge on September 30th. We need you to not just tune in, but we need you to be prepared to donate, to give towards this cause, because it really is something that we as a people have to change. It's not going to change unless we change it. Also, I wanted to remind us that each of us are working in this fight against sickle cell disease, and they can go to WDC MSCTAwareness.org. And that's for the campaign that Theron is running on the trait side. Also, MakingSickleCellHistory.com. Again, that's MakingSickleCellHistory.com. That's all spelled out. And you can go there and you can join the Stop Sickle Sex campaign there by just simply putting your email address in, and we put you on the email list, and then you'll know everything that's going on with the campaign. Like I said, you do not need to have sickle cell trait, thalassemia, or any of these traits in order to be a part. And the truth is, if you haven't tested, you might as well put your email in, because you might actually find something out that you didn't know.
Right. So, and what's important?
I just want to encourage people.
And what's important, Alan, is for people to know that really, I mean, we're out on the streets making a difference and doing screening, but we're going to need people's support, because one of the ways that we're going to have to change this is by petitions and by going to the Congress and going to the mayors of our cities to get people to join us so we can change policies. You know, we can get the word out, but it's really going to take effect when we can change policies, and that's what it's going to take. So we got to call it. Let me see who's this. You're live. What's the count?
What's happening, gentlemen? What's happening? What's happening? How
What's
you
up,
doing?
Man?
How you doing?
What's up? How you doing?
How my sickle cell warriors doing, baby?
Man, we good, man. We good.
All right, be safe.
You got hey Tone Capone, man. You got a comment on having sickle sex, man? What's the count on that with you, man?
Say that again.
I said, what's your count? What's the count with you on the conversation about having sickle sex?
Sickle sex.
Sickle sex, man.
S-E-X.
S-E, yeah, well, you got the spelling correctly. Yes.
Okay, so what do you mean by sickle sex? Do you mean two people with sickle cell having sex?
Or just a person with the trait not knowing, people not knowing that they have the trait or the disease and having sex and having a kid who could potentially have sickle cell disease.
Do you it's dangerous. You might as well play Russian roulette. To me, it's the same thing.
Right.
That's right. And
growing up, I have six kids, and all of them have the trait. So I have trained them on, so you get involved with somebody, if you go to that level, you need to ask them what's the next family.
Exactly.
You know,
that's right.
And you have to do this because people don't understand how serious sickle cell is. And what's pissing me off, this is supposed to be sickle cell awareness, but I haven't seen one damn commercial.
Thank you.
Well, we got to make up our own commercials.
That's right.
We're going to have to make up our own commercials, Tone Capone. So get your cell phone out.
No, I love, you know, don't get me wrong. No disrespect to anybody with cancer. My mom died from cancer. But sickle cell is killing just the other people's cancer. It's every day.
Yeah. Hey, I gotta take a quick break. I got No Pain in the Playroom is in the building, so I know they got some of their fan base out there listening. So I got to bring them on the camera on stage. So we're going to take about a 120-second break. I'll be right back. WDC Radio got Playroom Radio coming up. Don't go nowhere. Get tested.
A lot of crooks try to steal your heart. Never really had luck. Couldn't ever figure out how to love. How to love. Yeah. You had a lot of moments that didn't last forever. Now you on this corner trying to put it together. How to love. Had a love. Oh, for a second you were here, now you over there. It's hard not to stare the way you move in your body like you never had a love. Never had a love. Yeah, when you was just a young and your looks were so precious. But now you grown up so fly, it's like a blessing. But you can't have a man look at you for 5 seconds without you being insecure. You never credit yourself. So when you got older, it seemed like you came back 10 times overnight. Sitting here in the damn corner, looking over your thoughts and looking over your shoulder. See, you had a lot of crooks try to steal your heart. Never really had luck, couldn't ever figure out how to love. How to love. See, you had a lot of moments that didn't last forever. Now you on this corner, try and put it together. How to love, how to love. For a second you were here, now you over there. It's hard not to stare the way you move in your body like you never had a love. Never had a love. You had a lot of dreams that transformed the visions. The fact that you saw the world affected all your decisions, but wasn't your fault, wasn't in your intentions to be the one here talking to me, be the one listening. But I admire your popping bottles and pimping just as much as you admire bartending and stripping, baby. So don't be mad, nobody else tripping. You seen a lot of crooks and the crooks still crooks. See, you had a lot of crooks try to steal your heart. Never really in love, couldn't ever figure out how to love. Had a lot of moments that didn't last forever. Now you on this corner, try and put it together. How to love. How to love. See, I want you to know you're far from the usual. Far from the usual. See, I want you to know you're far from the usual. See, you had a lot of crooks try to steal your heart. Never really a luck, couldn't ever figure out how to love. How to love. See, you had a lot of moments that didn't last forever. Now you on this corner, try to put it together. How to love.
Look, I go hard. Haters always watching, I'm not stopping. I just do my thing till the money come a knocking. And I'm G5 with it, but sky's not the limit. And I'm the coldest sleeper when it comes to fly women. I just need a lady with no kids or even babies. That'd be bad to the bone, would be happy to come home. And if she acts a ditty, then she still coming with me. Y'all colors, it's a go. From C-Sun to Howard and the girls in between. If you dropping it, bottle popping, shawty looking mean. Yeah, you got it, yeah, you got it when you look at me. Right here on the floor, I just wanna know.
Little mama, it's cold. Yeah,
All right, welcome back. This is WDC Radio. I'm your host. I am WDC. I'm about to turn the airwaves over to my teammates over here. I got No Pain in the Playroom is in the building. What's up?
Hey, you know what time it is.
What's the count, man?
Man, we over here doing big things. It's Sickle Cell Awareness Month, and, you know, we just, you know, talking about Sickle Cell Awareness. Sickle Cell Awareness with the new stickers and everything like that. You know, we came rocking the hats. Of course, the hats say Team Sickle Cell on the back. It's Sickle Cell Awareness all month long, all around, bro.
That's right. Okay. Introduce your guest down there, man. That's his music playing in the background.
It's knocking,
shut him
too.
Out.
It's knocking.
We have
I'm D Martino.
In the house.
What's up, man? How you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. I'm chilling. I'm out here, you know, supporting the Sickle Cell Awareness Month. And you know, I love my cousin, and she's dealt with this sickle cell disease for a while now, and it's affected all of us, and I'm here for her. I love her, and let's do this, man. Let's get people aware of this, you know what I'm saying? Let's get
for
it in
sure,
the right,
man, for sure. I want to wrap up the conversation that we was having, then I'm going to let you guys take over the airways about having sickle sex, man. Any comments you want to say about stopping sickle sex in the community, man? What's your...
well, first, I just like to say that you... There's a choice that you can make. You know, there are choices and different things that go along with having sickle sex. You know, you can get with somebody and have the trait, and you both have the trait and be aware of that.
Right.
Yes. But as long as you're aware and know all of the different choices and the alternatives, you know, when it comes to, you know, anything, childbirth, whatever, you know, it's just
a
important
responsibility type of conversation.
Yeah,
because
you don't want to go into it blind.
Yeah.
You know, you don't want to go into anything blind like that.
Yeah. I was just going to say the same thing. You know, you have to be aware. You have to know your status. And if you feel that you don't know, you need to find out.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
It's not that hard. It's a blood test, easy stick, and then you're done.
Exactly.
Like, and it's not, I mean, it can be life-threatening if your child has it.
Right.
But if you're educated about this disease, then...
We can stop it.
Right.
We can stop. We can prevent it. And that's and that's really the conversation I want people to understand.
Right.
We're not saying that you can't have people going, it's God's will at the end of the day anyway.
Yeah.
But it's at least you get an informed, you know, conversation.
You know.
And you know, and if you do decide to have a child anyway, that you know what you're gonna be dealing with, you're gonna know what hospitals to go to, you're gonna know what kind of care to look for. So you'll be empowered.
Take that extra
step.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
That.
And being an advocate and everything like that. It's just really just important just to know your status and definitely know your choices. And I feel especially for me, you know, I'm in a newly formed relationship and my girlfriend actually has sickle cell. So,
exactly.
You know, it's something that I never really thought I would be a part of, you know, a relationship with somebody who has sickle cell. But
what made you?
It's just the choices, you know, man, like I couldn't, it was, we're not at the point of talking about children yet. So it's just me talking to her, and she outweighed all of the negative things.
Yeah.
She's, you know, she's amazing. So
exactly. You got any comments about the Stop and Sickle Sex campaign, man? Anything you just want to share with the...
Oh, man, just get educated. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's all we can do. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, get your tests and all that. You know what I'm saying? It's really important, you know, for our future, and you know what I'm saying? And
stopping the disease.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm gonna let you guys this is your time now, man. It's,
right,
you know,
well,
what
welcome
you...
to Playroom Radio, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, in the building, turning up.
Yep.
So we got D-Boy over here. We haven't talked to D-Boy since our first No Pain in the Playroom concert, where he turned it up. He's got some nice music out that we were just hearing in my ears, and you know, that's fire.
And so that's new, right? That's a new song, right?
Yeah, that's off my new album on Fast Life. It's a collective songs of, you know, just me as a youngin' just going through the trials and tribulations. I got a second little project coming up that's gonna be like, you know, it's gonna tell a story, you know what I'm saying? So it's pretty cool, you know. Everybody check it out.
I mean, we know who D-Boy is, but for the people that don't know, let us know who you are. What's your name? How old are you? Where
well,
you
from? I'm D-Boy, D-Martino. I've been rapping and singing since, like, I was, like, 15. I've been beatboxing since I saw Michael Jackson. That right when I saw, I was like, you know what I'm saying? So
probably came out the womb dancing.
Yeah, shoot, moonwalking. Like,
yeah.
But yeah, you know, I'm from Palmdale, California. You know what I'm saying? Repping it, you know, and just I love music. I love doing it, and you know that's what I love doing. You know, just making beats and. I was up all night last night just finishing up this beat because it was just crazy.
Right, I believe it, man. You know, yeah. You know, certain things like that can keep you up. Yeah. You know, especially when you're passionate about it. And how did you get so passionate about it?
Well, you know, I've been doing music since I was 15. So I started in the church. You know, I was in a positive. Rap group named North Star. And we toured all over Los Angeles, and it really That's affected cool. me, and I still got my bros to this day, you know what I'm saying, and I'm trying to bring them back, and this is a whole it's a long story. So that's just how I get inspired through God, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, absolutely, you know, so,
I want to ask you, you know, I know you support your cousin here with who has sickle cell disease, but personally, is there any other causes that you care about? Like, is there something out there in the world that you would donate part of your proceeds of your music to give, you know, to bring awareness to it? If it's not sickle cell, is it?
You know, I want to go to Africa. Yeah. Like, I really want to go out there. You know, I want to go to Italy and, you know, kind of like over there, just, you know, everybody needs something, you know what I'm saying? And I believe if I can help, I'm going to help everybody if I can, you know what I'm saying? So
is there a particular, like mentoring kids or just?
Oh yeah,
like,
I'm mentored too. Yeah.
So okay,
I'm
like, so there you go. So
I mentor, you know what I'm saying? So, I've been mentoring Joe. That's my boy, you know what I'm saying?
That's good.
And,
shout out to Joe.
Yeah.
That's cool, man. That's cool.
You know, I just try to do the positive thing, you know what I'm saying? I got little brothers, you know what I'm saying? So.
Shout out,
you know,
I take
care of my family, man. You know what I'm saying? You got to keep family first. You
exactly.
know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly.
It's always
cool,
family
man.
First.
Cool.
What type of music do you do?
I do like a blend. I do R&B, hip hop. I tend to like just get inspired, you know what I'm saying? And then just write about what you get inspired about, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of things inspire me, especially lately, you know what I'm saying? And you know, God bless our troops, you know what I'm saying?
Yes,
what happened this morning,
salute to the
you know
troops.
What I'm saying? Like,
it's my people's, man. That's my soldiers.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We got this craziness. You know, those are the people that fight for us every day, you know what I'm saying? And that's some crazy stuff that's going on. So, shout out to the troops.
I know we were going to share about some fallen soldiers. You have any?
Yeah, we do.
Yes. I got a few personal fallen soldiers. Mark Anthony Van and Charles McLemore. I recently lost those are like my brothers, man. It was tough losing them.
And we're talking about our community. These are fallen soldiers from the sickle cell community. It affects, you know, children, young adults. People are dying, and so we always want to acknowledge people who we've known who've been soldiers in this war on sickle cell, who have given their life to education and awareness, man.
And yes, and with that said, we got to bring up Miss Phyllis.
It
wouldn't be right.
Right. We wanted to shout out Miss Phyllis because she's done so much for everyone that was in her life when she was here. So shout out to Miss Phyllis.
Yeah,
for sure.
Man, like there's so many names. There was like an outpour of people on Instagram and
shout out to Pooh.
Yeah.
He, passed away a couple of years back, and his brother he represents heart for his brother
Marquise, right?
And he's actually doing a project. We were talking about it yesterday. He's doing documentaries and he's going to school, so shout out to the both of them.
So what's the Playroom got going on, man? When's the next Playroom concert, man? What's up? We got
we are working it out. I know this guy is going to be there, though.
Right.
Yeah, you already know. Let's do it.
Yeah.
We got to get him in the building.
There's no rush. We just got to make sure it's right.
That fall line is coming, though. Watch out for that.
Fall line's coming out.
Some nice stuff. We got our hoodies dropping the game. We going to have some new type of hoodies. You'll probably see me soon in the Born to Fight, Known to Win hoodie.
Hey, long sleeve t-shirt.
Yeah,
let's get it.
Yeah, yeah.
Sure.
New hats. I know a lot of people have been talking about, man, y'all always got the snapbacks. They cool and stuff, but where the fit is at? Where the fit is?
Right.
You know, they're dropping.
Right.
The fitters are coming.
So how's the awareness campaign going on, man? What's the count with the awareness campaign? You out in the schools? You out?
Awareness. Like we're everywhere.
We actually showing up just at? Went to a school talking to the little kids. Yeah, about
Auntie
style.
Ronnie's daycare, and the younger children.
And there's actually children in the class that have sickle cell, so we went to where their class members and teachers and everyone there. So
cool, man.
Yeah.
And we're also the girl's mother is putting on a walk, so we're talking to her about that.
Oh, okay.
As well.
Yep. And I know there's another walk coming up in Las Vegas. Isn't the second annual?
Oh, yeah. That's in October. Yeah. I heard that was going to be a little bit outside of the window of September, but
October 3rd, yeah.
Somewhere around.
I mean, and honestly, it's 365, man.
Exactly.
You know, I'm not going to sweat just because of September. You know, of course, I'm going to turn up a little bit more because it's Sickle Cell Awareness Month. And, I got to let people know. But this is my life. This is 365.
Yeah, it's every day. Yeah. You know, it's not. This is Sickle Cell Awareness Month, but we live with this every day.
Yeah.
And just because it's not September don't mean you can't still rep whatever you want.
Yeah.
For the cause.
You know, this is why, I'm always repping. I've always got my hat on. I'm wearing my Ventures hat today. It's not as new as Omika's. Hers is kind of fly over there.
I designed it myself. Thank you very much.
She did. Yeah.
Cool, man. Cool. Anything else you want to share with the listeners, man? We got a few more minutes left. About your guests or what,
I kind of like to hear that song again.
Right.
can we play that in the background?
Yep. Yeah. Shout out to everybody on Twitter. You can follow us on at the Playroom SCD on Instagram. You can follow us on No Pain in the Playroom.
And give out your information too, man, so they can follow you and find you out there, man.
So Twitter, dboy all day 87, and you can buy my album on iTunes, DMartino Fast Life. Look for me, man. Check me out.
You can follow me on Twitter. I'm at IMWDC. Instagram is the same, at IMWDC. And we got to put together some concerts. We got, I don't know if Jody, the line's still
going.
It's going to work. They got DBC. We got to get together and put on a benefit concert together, man. Jody's a gospel rapper. We got enough talent here, man, in the building to put our own.
Definitely.
Create
man.
Our own way.
I'm sure when the time is right, we'll all come together and it'll be something great. Right.
We also wanted to shout out, people that's doing things in for our community. It's a blood thing. Shout out to Jazz and her sister.
Yeah, baby Jasmine Castron. She's really, really cool. We've got, of course, our team. Then we have our...
Fix It For.
Yeah.
Shout out the girl for Sickle Cell, too.
Shout out the young,
Don't forget Voices of Sickle Cell.
Voices of Sickle Cell. The whole crew. And, The SCD Soldiers United. Yeah, shout out to Ty and Jewel Star.
Yes, shout out to them. They're doing it big.
Yeah, those are our East Coast crew.
Both of y'all.
Yep. Oh, also shout out to the Wire Radio crew, Lisa Brittany and EJ Perry, every Wednesday.
Hey,
they be turning it up.
They turn up.
Cool. That's our other favorite radio show.
Cool.
Of course, this one's our first.
We good, man. Spread the wealth, man. What you got? Shouts out, man. Anybody want to talk to?
To my brother Samuel and Chris, and And shout out to the soldiers out there, And look me up, Keep in touch. Twitter.
You performing anywhere anytime soon, or you waiting for
Right now, I've actually just been doing my mostly pre-production for my my up and coming album. So I'm just really trying to get that. I'm doing more singing. It's gonna be cool because I have a couple tracks on this album where I'm singing and stuff. Having to do with the past relationship I went through. So I just
You gotta get it out somehow, right?
Gotta put it on the table
Y'all need to check that out on iTunes.
Definitely. Yeah, it was about an abusive relationship with a friend, and we end up, I end up telling her that I've loved her since when she was in that relationship. So it's cool, you know what I'm saying? It kind of's relatable, you know what I'm saying?
Of course.
I think people will be like, oh, smart, you know, you go through that too.
Yeah.
Let's
yeah.
rock out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So I party, yeah. so you know what I'm saying?
Come so I'm shows. Saying, man, I'm saying we look at the calendar, man, and like 90 days out, man, drop a concert, man, somewhere, man. What's
I'm with it, bro.
90 days out. That's enough time to promote
you with it, D-Boy?
Yeah, yeah.
90 days?
That'd be good.
Yep. You know, I'm always going to be down for the cause, man. You know, I put on for the Band-Aid Gang. Hey. Band-Aid Gang Generals Band-Aid over here. Mm-hmm. You know, the all brand right. with the two little Band-Aids. Boom.
So I'm going to give you like a few seconds left. What do you want the world to know about sickle cell, man?
That it does not control your life. It does not. And I mean, I live a beautiful life. I mean, I've got beautiful friends. You guys, exceptionally.
For sure.
You all have, you know, you have sickle cell. And it doesn't make us any lesser of people.
Right.
You know, we can still be great.
Oh, what you got?
We
got
to stick together.
Yes.
Stop hating. Right. Let's pull together and let's do this thing. If we want to build a greater community, we need to stick together.
Exactly.
Yeah, take it to the top.
Doesn't matter if you have the trait. Doesn't have to matter if you have the trait of disease, a thalassemia. It's all
SSSC.
Exactly. It don't matter. If we come together, we'll be stronger.
Exactly.
Because just like Jazz said, it's a blood thing. We all got blood in our veins, running through our veins. Not David Blaine.
All right. But, well, this is WDC Radio. Man, this is Playroom Radio, the last few minutes here. I just want to thank everybody for tuning and listening in. Next week, you can catch me here again, WDC Radio, 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, 2 p.m. Eastern. Don't forget, you got to come back. September 30th is
September
the pledge. 30th.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can perform live. I'm inviting you live here on this for the place. September 30th, so you guys
September
be back.
September 30th.
All right. I'm working on getting a couple hours here at the station. That'll be that. You can text the word trait to 41242. Text the word trait to 41242. You can follow me on Twitter at IMWC, and I'll put out information about the pledge and who's going to be here performing live. I got a few people. I got Rayo. She's going to be here too, so...
Yeah.
Ness, man, thank you, man, back there running everything for me, man. I appreciate you, man. And again, just follow us. I am WDC.
Find me on at facebook.com/ We Want Diamond Ray. I dropped a new poem yesterday. Check that out. It's called Michelle for my mama.
Oh.
Happy birthday, mom.
You can follow me on Instagram, Omiko Mai, and Twitter at the same name.
All right.
Yep.
You good?
And shout Twitter, D-Boy All Day 87. You know what I'm saying? And, find me at www.insomniacmusic, both with K's.com. Check me out.
All right, cool. All right, thank you for listening. Thank you for tuning in. We'll be back next week.
Are you having sickle sex?
Sickle sex?
Yeah, sickle sex. You won't know unless you've been tested.
Really? You can really get sickle cell from having sex?
No, but your baby can. If you carry the sickle cell trait, you could possibly have a baby with a sickle cell disease. Find out more today and get tested. This message brought to you by SCD Soldier Network.
This is Girl for Sickle Cell, and sickle cell has waged a war against our community, and it's time to fight back.
What is sickle cell?
Sickle cell disease is an inherited blood disorder where your red blood cells do not get enough oxygen. Over 100,000 people in the United States are affected by sickle cell.
100,000 people?
Yes.
How can we help?
Join me today in the fight against sickle cell by visiting me on Facebook or follow me on Twitter at Girl for Sickle Cell. That's G-U-R-L, the number 4, sickle cell. Again, G-U-R-L, the number 4, sickle cell.
Let's stop the war today.
One heart, let's get together and
tienes